Hertoghe sign or Queen Anne sign is a thinning or loss of the outer third of the eyebrows. It was described by the Belgian internist Eugene Ludovic Christian Hertoghe, a native of Ambert who worked in Brussels. Eugene Hertoghe is considered the first pioneer in thyroid function research. In this image, you can clearly appreciate this sign, the loss in this case, or thinning or impoverishment of the eyebrow in its outermost third. Hertoghe presented his observations on eyebrow alopecia in hypothyroid patients at the International Surgery Congress, Colombia, in 1914. In addition to this sign, Hertoghe drew many other clinical conclusions of hyperthyroidism, the result of careful and repeated observation of this pathology whose study he dedicated his whole life. Hertoghe's work achieved great recognition from his contemporaries, even holding the position of Vice President of the Royal Academy of Medicine of Belgium. This sign is also called the Queen Anne sign. This name is based on the association with the portrait of Queen Anne of Denmark, a fragment of which you can see here. In this portrait, which represents her in mourning for the death of her son Enrique in 1612, a loss of the external third of the eyebrow can be seen, although historically there is no evidence that she suffered from hypothyroidism. As we have commented, Hertoghe described this sign associated with hypothyroidism, which is why it became a classic sign of this disease. But it is also a frequent sign that we can find associated with atopic dermatitis. Thallium poisoning, Lepromatous leprosy, and prior to Hertoghe, Jean Alfred Fournier had described eyebrow tail alopecia, observing it on some passengers while riding public transport in Paris. And this eyebrow waxing that he observed related to the frequent cases of secondary syphilis that were so common then. It is this medical doctor and the way in which he observed this sign, in this case associated with secondary syphilis, which also receives the curious name of the omnibus sign, a name given to the horse-drawn carriages used as public transport at the time.